स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी शैल स्टडी और वी शैल डू क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 ऑफ 11.1 एक्सरसाइज क्लास 10th मैथ्स. स्टेटमेंट इज कंस्ट्रक्ट एन आइसोसेलेस ट्रायंगल हुज बेस इज 8 सेंटीमीटर एंड एल्टीट्यूड 4 सेंटीमीटर एंड देन अनदर ट्रायंगल हुज साइड आर 1/2 टाइम्स द कोरस्पोंडिंग साइड्स ऑफ द आइसोसेलेस ट्रायंगल. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शैल चेंज दिस मिक्सड फ्रैक्शन ऑफ 1/2 इंटू अ सिंपल फ्रैक्शन और इंटू ए पी अपॉन क्यू फॉर्म. सो 2 1s are 2 एंड 2 + 1 3. सो वी विल गेट 3/2. सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी शैल टेक द बेस ऑफ आवर ट्रैंगल ऑफ आवर आइसोसेलेस ट्रैंगल एज 8 सेंटीमीटर एंड आफ्टर दैट वी शैल make two equal sides like this. Okay, now these equal sides represents that this triangle is an isosceles triangle. So what is special in isosceles triangle? In isosceles triangle, two sides of the triangle should be equal. What it means, in an isosceles triangle the two sides length of a triangle is equal. Okay, so and we have to make the altitude 4 cm in this triangle, altitude like this. And we want to construct another triangle whose side are 3/2 times the corresponding sides of this isosceles triangle. I hope you have understood the statement of this question. Now I am going to start this question. So please see carefully. First, I shall take the base of this isosceles triangle as 8 cm. Okay. So here I am taking the base as 8 cm. So students, this is the base. I shall name this as AB and this is 8 cm. Okay, now students, the next step is we have to make the altitude of 4 cm. And what will we do to make the altitude 4 cm on this baseline AB 8 cm? First, we shall take the perpendicular bisector of this AB line. And for taking the perpendicular bisector, what we have to do, students, please see, this AB is of 8 cm. And for taking the perpendicular bisector, we have to open our compass more than half of this AB side or AB length. Suppose this is, we know that the length of this AB is 8 cm. So we have to open our compass more than its half. Means we have to open the compass more than 4 cm. We can open 4.5 cm or we can open 5 cm or 5.5 cm or 6 cm. So I'm not going to take the decimal points. So I'm going to take the whole number as 5 cm. So students, using the scale, measure the 5 cm like this. Okay, this is 5 cm. Now for taking the perpendicular bisector, I shall put my compass at the point A and make an arc in the upward or in the upward and in the downward direction like this. Okay, students, please listen carefully. For taking the perpendicular bisector, I shall open my compass more than half of this length. Here we have been given the length of 8 cm, so I have opened my compass more than 4 cm and I have taken 5 cm. So from the point A I have made this arc and this arc below, and same I shall do from the point B. Okay, so from the point B I shall cut like this in the upward direction or in the downward direction. So here you can see these arcs are not meeting, so I shall join them again. So this is the intersecting point. Students, please erase the extra portion of these arcs. It is not required in this question. So now join these intersecting points of the arcs with a dotted line. Okay, and students, name this point of this dotted line and the base, this point as D. Okay, so I have given the intersecting point of this dotted line and the base, this as a D. Okay, now what will we do? Name these two intersecting points, this as O and this point as O dash. Okay, and now from the point D I shall make an arc of altitude 4 cm. So first of all, open your compass of 4 cm. So this is 4 cm. So फॉर मेकिंग द एल्टीट्यूड 4 सेंटीमीटर आई शैल पुट माई कंपास एट पॉइंट डी एंड देन आई शैल मेक एन आर्क ऑन दिस डॉटेड लाइन. प्लीज स्टूडेंट्स सी हेयर द लेंथ ऑफ दिस इज 4 सेंटीमीटर एंड इट इज द एल्टीट्यूड ऑफ दिस ट्रायंगल. ओके नाउ द इंटरसेक्टिंग पॉइंट ऑफ दिस डॉटेड लाइन एंड दिस आर्क इज दिस एंड नेम दिस पॉइंट एज सी एंड नाउ जॉइन दिस पॉइंट सी विद पॉइंट ए. Now join this point C with B. Okay. Now students measure this AC. AC is almost 5.5 centimeter. Okay. Now measure this CB. This is also again 5.5 centimeter. So students, AC is almost 5.6 centimeter and CB is also 5.6 centimeter. Okay, so you can see here that the length of AC and the length of CB is same, and that is 5.6 centimeter. And for making the isosceles triangle, we should have the length of two sides of the triangle equal. So due to these two sides AC and CB of equal length, this triangle ABC is representing the isosceles triangle. I am repeating myself, in the isosceles triangle there is a speciality that in this triangle the length of two sides of a triangle is equal. So here in this case the AC and CB are of equal lengths, and due to that this triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Okay, now students, we have to construct another triangle whose sides are I have written this into the simple fraction 3/2, whose sides are 3/2 times the corresponding sides of the isosceles triangle. Now students, please listen this carefully. Here we have been given the ratio of 3/2. So here you can see the numerator is greater than denominator. So I have already told you in my previous videos that if numerator is greater than denominator, it means the new triangle will come outside this triangle. Okay, due to the greater value of numerator, we come to know about the position of triangle whose sides are 3/2. So the new triangle will come outside this triangle due to the greater value of this numerator. And students, out of this numerator and denominator, this 3 is larger. So we shall make 3 arcs on the line AX, which I am going to draw at an acute angle from the point A. So first of all, make a line at an acute angle from the point A. So this is the line. So this is the line at an acute angle from the point A. So out of this 3 and 2, 3 is greater. So it means we have to draw 3 arcs on this line. Okay. And students, notice carefully that the length of all the 3 arcs should be equal or should be same. Okay. So open your compass. And now students, whatever the compass you have opened now, you don't have to change the compass after making the first arc. Okay. You have no need to change the compass, or you have no need to open your compass more or less after making the first arc. So students, please notice here. Please see carefully. From the point A, make first arc like this. Okay. And from this arc, I shall make another arc of equal length like this. And from this point, arc A2, I shall make arc A3 like this. Okay. And the point which should be noticed here, we have to draw these arcs of equal length. It means we shall not change our compass length whatever we have taken from this point. Okay. Now name this as arc A1, arc A2, arc A3. So this is arc A1, this is arc A2, this is arc A3. Now students, what we shall do next? Out of this numerator and denominator, always remember you have to join the denominator with the point B. It means you have to join this second arc with point B. Always join the denominator with the point B. Okay, here we are having the second, or we are having the 2, so we will join our second arc with point B. So joining the arc A2 with point B. Okay, so I have joined the arc A2 with point B. Now students, what is the next step? In the next step, we shall make a parallel line from the A3 to this line AB. For that, we have to produce this AB line. So I'm going to produce this AB line. So produce the AB line like this. And now, students, from the arc A2, make an arc like this. Okay, from the arc A2, make an arc like this. Students, notice here, you will not change the compass opening. Means whatever you have opened the compass here for making this arc, you have to maintain that distance. Okay, so with the same opening of that compass, we shall make an arc from the arc A3. Okay, so students, please listen again. First, I have draw an arc from A2. Okay, and after that, I have draw an arc from A3 with the same opening of that compass. Okay, now students, measure this length. Now students, measure this length with the compass, this length. So after measuring the length with the compass, we shall put our compass at this point and make an arc like this. This arc should cut this arc, so I shall extend this arc up to this. So this is the intersecting point of these two arcs. Now students, join this intersecting point with A3 and extend this up to this point. Okay, now join this intersecting point with A3 and extend this line. Students, these two lines should be parallel, so I am erasing this. There is some mistake in making the line, so I shall join this line again. So joining the point A3 with this intersecting point, now students, you can see these two lines are parallel. So I have drawn a parallel line A3 and name this as B dash. So I have drawn a parallel line A3 B dash to the A2 B. So please listen again. First of all, I have made an arc from A2 like this, and with the same opening of that compass, I have made the arc from the A3, and after that I have measured the distance of this arc, and then after measuring the distance, I have put the compass at this point and make an arc like this. Okay, and the intersecting point I have joined with A3 and extended up to the B dash point. Okay, so I have drawn a parallel line A3 B dash to the line A2 B. So what is our next step? We shall make an arc from the point B like this. Okay, so I have made an arc from the point B like this. Okay, so without changing the compass, from the point B dash, I shall make an arc like this. Okay, without changing the compass, from the point B dash, I have made an arc like this. Okay, now students, measure this length of the arc with the compass. Now measure this length of the arc with the compass, and on pointing the compass at this point, make an arc like this. Okay, now students, produce this AC line like AB. So produce this AC line. Okay, now after this, join this intersecting point with B dash and produce this line up to this line. Okay, so join this intersecting point with the B dash. And extend this AC line. And students, name this intersecting point as C dash. Okay, so name this point intersecting point C dash. Okay, so students, I have made another parallel line B dash C dash to the BC. Okay, I have made another parallel line B dash C dash to the BC. So students, this ABC is our isosceles triangle, and this is the altitude of 4 centimeter. So this is from the point C to D, the altitude of this isosceles triangle, and this altitude of from point C to D is of 4 centimeter, and this ABC is our isosceles triangle, and we want to construct another triangle whose sides are 3/2 times the corresponding sides of the isosceles triangle. So we have constructed another triangle A B dash C dash whose sides are 3/2 times the corresponding sides of the isosceles triangle, which is ABC. So A B dash C dash is our new triangle whose sides are 3/2 times the corresponding sides of the isosceles triangle, which is ABC. Okay.